Okay, see that guy, his name is Antione William Tuckson, 37, of Maryland. He was posing as a deputy U.S. Marshal. He had weapons, had police-style vehicles, realistic-looking IDs, and even a trained, and this is in quotes, bite dog. All right, keep his picture up. According to a statement Monday from the U.S. Attorney's Office for the District of Maryland, Tuckson is accused of impersonating a federal officer and being a felon in possession of a firearm. Tuckson has been posing as a law enforcement officer across multiple states for the past 15 years. Tuckson was first charged with impersonating an officer in West Virginia in 2006. But the charges were dropped. In 2009, he was arrested in D.C. on charges related to impersonating again. But the case was overturned on appeal, dropped. Then in 2018, according to a Charles County Sheriff's Office report, Tuckson responded to a robbery in progress at a bar and identified himself as a U.S. Marshal to both the victim and the police. Hold the hell up. When did the U.S. Marshal start responding to robberies in progress? Okay, he got away with it. Let's show some of the imagery of the artillery, handcuffs, badges. These things were recovered during his arrest on March 6th, all right? He even had U.S. Marshal K-9 unit badges, police U.S. Marshal tags for his vehicle, U.S. Marshal K-9 unit tags. I might have made these tags for him. Investigators also found a printer for making ID cards, fake U.S. Marshals ID cards, with embedded computer chips to resemble those used by federal government officials, body armor, and a sophisticated security system. Once again, 15 years. A search warrant of Tuckson's house also turned up an AR-15 style rifle and a pistol grip pump action shotgun. Now, did he have help? According to the authorities, he did. Tuckson's accused accomplice, Najia Nicole Rich, 40, of Baltimore, is also charged with impersonating a federal officer and conspiracy to impersonate a federal officer. Prosecutor says Ms. Rich posed as Tuckson's supervisor on the phone when police began to question Tuckson's status as a U.S. Marshal. Both were arrested Friday, and if convicted, Tuckson and Rich each face a maximum of 3 years in prison on the impersonation charge. The conspiracy charge against Rich carries a maximum of 5 years. Tuckson also faces a maximum of 10 years in prison on the charge of being a felon in possession of a firearm. The rules started to unravel earlier this year after Tuckson became a security guard at a restaurant by holding himself out to be a deputy U.S. Marshal. Okay? So, it's not even a great cover story. He says he's a deputy U.S. Marshal, but he wants to be security at this particular facility. In March, while Tuckson was on duty at the restaurant with his patrol dog, Tuckson tried to detain two women who had disputed the bill and were attempting to leave the restaurant, according to the prosecutors. When the women fled, Tuckson pursued them down the road, where he encountered responding officers from the Prince George's County Police Department. All right, so here come the real police. He's a fake police, but he is working with the real police now to apprehend this person. Tuckson displayed a fake badge, falsely identified himself to the officers as a deputy U.S. Marshal. The cops, however, were suspicious. Why? Because Tuckson left his K-9 at the restaurant. And on-duty K-9s are trained to never leave an assigned officer's side. Can we put up a picture of the K-9? You done brought the damn dog into this.
Dog's gotta eat, Dr. Richey.
Come on, man. This is a beautiful dog. When Prince George's officers began questioning him about his purported status as a marshal, prosecutors say Miss Rich, his accomplice, then posed over the phone as Tuckson's supervisor to vouch for him. Eventually, prosecutors said Rich showed up at the scene in tactical pants, a bulletproof vest, and what appeared to be an extendable baton, and told officers the dog was her emotional support animal in addition to being a patrol dog. Okay. Let's put up the pictures again, explain what's happening here. All right. On the left, the dog was later handed over to the county's animal services division. But Miss Rich was able to retrieve the dog the next day after showing up in police style clothing and telling the animal service officers the dog belonged to a U.S. Marshal. They fell for it again. In late 2020, Tuckson registered the trademark USMS Special Services and registered multiple vehicles in that name. USMS, United States Marshal Service. Two of the vehicles were equipped with flashing red and blue lights and a forged document from the Maryland Motor Vehicle Administration registering the two vehicles as emergency vehicles was also recovered in the house search. The document is on the right. Listen, man. Listen, brother. Why not just become the police? I mean, they have hired convicted felons before.
Yep.
We have reported on this right here. And I guarantee you would have found somebody in this country willing to hire you. I'm glad that this individual has been caught. We don't know what else this was used for. I just have to imagine it was used for more than just kicks. That there was some level of either or something else happening here.
My question to the prosecutors, and look, let's be clear, nobody should be impersonating a police officer.
Yeah.
Having said that, did this fake cop respect people's First, Fourth, right. Fifth Amendment rights?
Yeah.
Because if he did, then that's better than a lot of cops that are out there probably in that same Prince George's County department who do not show that same level of respect for ordinary citizens.
That's actually
so
true.
Yes, throw the book at him because he impersonated a cop, but let's also maybe somehow say, look, the guy's clearly creative. He clearly put a lot of effort into this. If he respected people's rights, and let's use this and say he was an exemplary police officer in how he interacted with the public.
You know, this literally reminds me of a movie that Martin Lawrence was in, where he impersonated a cop. Does anybody remember the name of that movie? He impersonated a cop in order to get a diamond back. All right, that he had stolen from a robbery. Anyway, I'm sure somebody in the chat.
Money Chase.
That's what it was? It may not have been. I don't think it was Money Chase. All right, we'll get it. I know Inquiring Minds would like to know.